Thank you. Oh. Stop spending so much fucking money. The resolution just a little bit there. It's looking a little laggy on the stream, man.
Thank you.
to get a real job.
And now your complaint is the monster's too powerful to control. Well, fuck you. That's your fault.
And, you know, and the other thing is, some people have said, this is ridiculous. Get another job.
Doing a 9-to-5 would be easy.
Possibly a good job.
Yeah, there you go.
Do you not see that I've already my whole day is here on stream? Like, I'm here around 9:00.
Yeah, because the rat roaches is right there.
I will actually start making up money next year to pay down my credit card.
There's no really good A people in there. Jose.
And it's just
everything's bad in your life, dude.
Viewers. Let's think about that for a second.
He doesn't really have friendship. He's trying to forget to get sick. How much work can I someone's life falling apart at the seams every day because the shit you do, the concrete perfect you do something every fucking day, and sleep in that fucking bed and get a sound sleep. I couldn't. Goddamn, dude, that's depressing as fuck. That was my depression. Ladies and gentlemen, depression is caused by eating fast food. Didn't you know that? It's 10 and 12. Every single thing he comes in is toxic. It's toxic. Every fucking day is toxic. Every day he's here.
Let me try switching up. Oh, I can't switch the frame rate up. I can't cap the frame rate. I can't do anything.
Balance for idiots. There you go. Invest more money, idiots. Kids are idiots. Kids are complete idiots. They actually pay me money to do this. That's how dumb these people are.
It's to the point where I know that... I know it's possible to get through it. I've been through so much shit. Dude, guys, 10 years. 10 fucking years of how many things have I come up against? False copyright strikes. Getting my channel shut down. YouTube adpocalypse. Trying to get me kicked off of Twitch. Trying to get me off of YouTube. Trying to, you know what I mean? Like, all this stuff has happened over the years. And I somehow got through it all. I can't... This is just a point where I give up.
Stop being a drama queen.
I love the drama.
Be a drama queen.
I love it. I create the drama.
Relax. Chamoli. Holy chamolis. What is going on? Why can't people just relax? Why can't people just relax? Relax! That's what I don't want on the street. I don't want people running around like Benny Hill. Going really, really acting chaotic, being all dramatic.
Alright, well anyway guys, I just want to say thank you, I told you that this is more important than me updating the leaderboard arena. I want to say thanks to everyone who did contribute during the stream. I'm gonna end it now, and get stuff uploaded to YouTube so I can start cooking.
Much.
And go from there. And what I'm gonna say is thank God tonight I get to spend some time with Kathy, and we're gonna have Thanksgiving night together. I'll be back tomorrow. Full-time streaming, like always, streams and gameplay and everything, and, up to this point, I've not allowed this to negatively affect me on the streams, and I'm going to do my best to not let it move forward. I got so much positive stuff coming up. We've got all the playthroughs I'm doing, we've got holiday events coming up for Christmas and everything, but the thing is, you guys know the ways you can help.
Pledge today. Give me your money. Oh, money. Give me money. Money that I gotta spend, endlessly spend money. It's addictive. Money.
Plus,
help me, money. Money. Ooh, money! Give me money! I need money. It's no cash grab. Cash grab. I have to go collect money or something. I'm only interested in the money.
In particular, the thing that gets me is I know there's people on YouTube who watch the videos on YouTube and everything I do. I basically overextended myself to the point where I'm like, there is no, okay, what else can I fall back on? I'm at my wit's end. It's really mentally, I'm at my wit's end. I can't take it anymore. You get these fucking guys and shit. Daily. Morally ignoring the fact that they know what they're doing is fucking wrong. And they do it just for fucking jolly or for some game. They think it's okay. And you watch that shit, you're like disgusting, vile fucking fuck. You can come from every next. You know? What's been done to me is far worse than if someone had beaten me within my inch of my life, because I could have recovered from that and been fine. The things they're doing to me destroy me financially and put me in a horrendous situation where even though I work my ass off and people tell me everything I'm doing is good, I can still lose everything. And, you know, I just don't understand it. I don't. Alright, guys. I gotta end this. So that's it. Thank you for at least letting me listen to me dish a little bit. You know, anything you guys can do to support is appreciated. And I hope everyone watching this live on Thanksgiving has a happy Thanksgiving. And I hope to see you all tomorrow. Alright? Thanks to everyone who's very, very supportive on the stream. People who are really supportive on the stream. I appreciate it. And tomorrow's another day, and hopefully things are better. Alright, guys? Alright, everyone. Happy Thanksgiving. Thank you very much. And I'll see you tomorrow. Later.
10 days.
By the way, I should say this. I appreciate, you know, if you guys do contribute here on Twitch, if you cheer some and tip while I'm doing this video.
It's gross. It's for this. It's not because they love what they're doing. It's not because of the love of the game or because they're true gamers. It's for this. And this is what it's become. It's not about putting out a quality review. It's not about putting out a quality playthrough or quality stream. It's about making this. I mean, it's rare when I have to come out and say, guys, we really need tons of money today. When do I say that, right? Very rarely, like I said, the one time was the end of last year when the tax situation came up out of nowhere. I don't feel like I'm in a situation where I do those kind of things. You know, there are sadly people out there who exploit. And they find ways to exploit constantly. Today is June 6, 2018. I have horrible news. And, you know, I cried. Emotional, very, very emotional. Now my throat is starting to close up. Wow, that's one of the weird things I've ever heard actually about, but it's really genuinely emotional. YouTube's now gone.
I got a couple dancing
while
they're giving me
I have news that may be some of the worst news I've ever brought to myself as a content creator on the internet. This is not good. Basically, some really horrible stuff is going on right now behind the scenes with YouTube. I really don't have full clarity on what's happening, but what I can do is tell you guys exactly what I did this morning. Do you want to play the fucking game? In regards to my YouTube channel, DSP Gaming, Today I saw a message I've never seen before ever in the entirety of the time I've used YouTube. 10 years I've used YouTube.
Easiness?
I've never seen this message before. It's a big red block and it says, all of your content is hidden. Click here to enable content or click here to learn more. Hidden. Okay, what does that mean? I look below at my channel, my video manager, all the videos that I've uploaded yesterday. They're all there. They're all enabled for advertisements. There's nothing that says copyright, nothing. But they're all set to private. And there's no edit button on the video, okay, in order to change that. So I'm like, what must be going on? I've never seen anything like this, right? So I'm trying to figure this out. So first of all, there's two options. It says either enable content, right, enable one, or learn more. I click on enable, and it brings me to an error page where a big error message pops up. Your channel needs to be linked to a valid name in order to progress. Do that first, then try again. What? What does that mean? I don't know. Never heard anything like this before. So I close that out. Apparently that's not going to work, right? So I click on learn more, okay? Learn more takes me to the page that says, so your content has been disabled. This is one of the Google Help pages, okay? It's supposed to explain what happened. And it says, you know, content can be hidden or disabled for various reasons. It could be because your channel was banned. It could be because your channel was suspended. It could be because you chose to suspend the content. You know, basically, it's like a bunch of reasons. But it even says right there, if your channel had any issues, you'll get a notification, which I didn't. I got nothing. Okay, zero. So it says there's a button here, and it says, click this button to create, like, a new page or a new channel name or whatever to link your channel to, and then all your content will become visible again. I click on that link. It gives me the same error message. You need to link to a valid name in order to continue. Do that first and then come back. So I'm dead in the water, all right? So now, I say, all right, let me try to figure this stuff out. All right, let me see, let me look at my channel standing, because there's actually something that says channel in your settings on YouTube. You click on it, it should tell you, oh, are you in good community standing? Are you in good copyright standing? Do you have the ability to upload videos? Yada, yada, yada. I click on it, page 500, internal server error. What?
Unbelievable.
Okay, this is weird. So I try to go to YouTube settings, page 500, internal server error. Okay, so I go up, if you're actually logged into a YouTube page, you gotta go to the upper right-hand corner of the screen, and there's a drop-down with your Google login information, okay? So I go to my Google login information, and click on, you know, settings. 500, internal server error. What the fuck? What does that mean, you know? Now I'm like, what does that, you know, this is wild and insane. What is going on?
I love karma.
I can't even access any pages that should tell me what the hell is happening in this regard. All right. So immediately I put up a tweet on Twitter. I have no idea what's going on. I tweet Team YouTube, which is their Twitter support team. Please help. I don't know what the hell's going on. All right. In the meantime, YouTube has an email address, which they provide to people who have 100,000 subscribers or more. And I have that email address. I email them immediately, not knowing if they're going to respond or not, saying, here's the situation. What do I do? And then I emailed Kurse. I actually sent an email to Kurse, my network, my partner network on YouTube, to let them know what's going on and say, hey, if there's any way you guys can help behind the scenes, please let me know, because I have no idea what's happening right now. I'm in the dark. I receive no messages from YouTube or anything. I have no idea what's going on or how to fix this. Okay? So, this is what's going on right now. Okay? So, I'm in the dark. I'm completely stumped. I don't know what to do. Just kind of sitting around, and I'm like, well, I guess I'm going to stream on Twitch today and have to see what happens, right? Because I can't control this. I don't know what's happening, you know? And this sucks. Again, I'm very, very, very worried, all right? Because
I need that money. I really do. I need that money for my bills.
YouTube is significant income for me. It would be one thing if my YouTube channel were just, oh, I just do it for fun. At this point, Twitch has overtaken what I do on YouTube, and I don't think... significant big chunk of my income. Like, no lie, make no bones about it. What I do on YouTube still pays the bills. Without that income, I can't pay my bills. And I don't know what the fuck to do. I'm like, have no clue what I'm gonna do. Alright? So, I'm, you know, worried. Okay? Now, that's not where it ended. I was actually about to start streaming on Twitch, and I got a response from Team YouTube over on Twitter. And they said,
fuck you, you fucking greedy piece of shit. Go fuck yourself.
Phil, here's a link. Click on this. This will be for our support page where you can either email or do a chat or whatever. I said, well, I already sent an email. Maybe that's all I can do. When I clicked on it, it also, there's a new live chat option. I had no idea that they have live chat support on YouTube. I figured it wasn't anyone who, like, was local, and I was right. Because I just tell you, as soon as I started talking to the person, they weren't typing in proper grammar. So, probably outsourced. So, it's probably someone sitting at a call center. But maybe they do have access to information or whatever. Who knows, right? At least there's something. At least there's something that I can talk to a human immediately and get some kind of information. Maybe they can help. Okay. So, I get into a live chat with a person. I explain the situation. They say, all right, we're looking into it. 10 minutes pass. 15 minutes pass. Finally, they come back. And they say, Phil, all right, we've got an update for you. Here's what's going on. Okay? We believe that your Google Plus account has been suspended. My Google Plus account? Huh? I don't use Google Plus. Ah! Okay, guys, so let's talk. Years ago, I believe it was around 2013, 2014, it might have been 2015, but I think it was around 2014-ish, okay? YouTube forced everyone who was going to continue to use their website to have a Google Plus account. Yeah, I'm a gamer! So I said, my Google Plus account has been suspended. And I said, but Google Plus is separate from my YouTube channel, right? And the person said, yes, but you're right, your YouTube channel is linked to this Google Plus account. And therefore, since the Google Plus account got suspended, essentially it has suspended your YouTube channel too because of the link between the two. Okay, well that's great, but why is my channel, why not my channel, why is my Google Plus account suspended? This doesn't even make sense to me. I don't, you know, I got no notice or anything. Well, looked into it, came back about 5 minutes later.
Well, the system is coming up and saying it was suspended for spam.
Spam? Now, wait a minute. All that I upload to my YouTube channel, DSP Gaming, is gameplay videos. And they're ongoing, unique videos of an ongoing series of a video game, right? So, it's not spam. It's actually 10 years I've been doing this style of video for the internet. There's no problem. Again, YouTube had no problem with the video. It wasn't that YouTube said, oh, you violated our guidelines or whatever. Somehow, Google Plus, behind the scenes of everything that was linked to my YouTube channel, decided, oh, this is spam, and shut down the Google Plus account. And because the Google Plus account got shut down or suspended, it froze all the content on DSP Gaming. It's still there, but it's all hitting automatically. So my in reality, my DSP Gaming channel has done nothing wrong. There's nothing wrong with DSP Gaming whatsoever. As a channel, it's in good standing with YouTube. The problem is, it was linked to a Google Plus account that something, probably a bot, right, a new algorithm from YouTube, was running and determined that because my Google Plus account was linked to my YouTube channel, my YouTube channel puts out, what, you know, 20, 30 posts a day with a new video, that apparently that's considered spam via Google Plus standards, and apparently shut down my YouTube channel as well as my Google Plus account. What? Now again, gotta emphasize here, 10 years I've been doing this for a living.
A 10-year legacy.
8 years DSP Gaming has been in existence. Since whenever they instituted the Google Plus link, okay, I've been uploading the same amount of videos on a daily basis, and it took until 2018 for somehow this account to be flagged as spam and be suspended. Huh? So literally, there's no trial, there's no jury, there's not even a system by which, oh, you did several violations, just, it's been automatically detected as spam, therefore you're shut down. Wow, isn't that exciting? And isn't that a great effective system, right? DSP Gaming, because it has such a wide history of having, you know, 8 years of videos, every day, yes, I do bring in views on my new videos, but that's paired with the old legacy videos that get thousands of views a day. So, the reason that DSP Gaming is successful and still makes me money is because it's an 8-year legacy, alright? If this were just a channel where I was uploading new videos every day, the videos I was uploading would not be significant income at all. It's a combination of the new video content plus all the archived video content that constantly brings me in revenue, alright? So, you know, DSP Gaming now being suspended because it's linked to a suspended Google Plus account, number one, this is big money I'm losing. Like, no lie, guys, today, right now, I'm losing big money.
The money is mine, and I want the money. We need more money. We need more money. That's what this stream is about.
And this isn't good because, you know,
I need that money to pay my bills. It's greed. It's greed. Greed is massively strong. I have no fucking self-control.
I'm in a situation now where I'm finally getting out of a tax situation with my state here. I'm finally going to be out of that, but now I've got taxes. I got to pay the federal government, and I got to pay my bills. If I don't pay my bills, I'm screwed. I'm going to go bankruptcy here. And in reality, I mean, this is real talk. If I can't get DSP Gaming back, I think I might have to go bankruptcy. I don't know what else to do. Unless my Twitch channel can somehow explode exponentially, and people coming to my Twitch channel start being so supportive to make up for the total amount of lost ad revenue on DSP Gaming. You know, I wish that my life could be stripped of all responsibility, and I could be teleported to a fantasy world where I can just do whatever I want. I don't know what I'm going to do, okay? Not good. This is really horrible, really bad. Now, some people have said, well, Phil, why don't you just go to another channel, another YouTube channel?
Laziness?
You know, you have your vlogging channel, And you have another channel, KO Gaming, to stop using, you know, a year ago. And you have other channels you can upload content to. That's true. But I'm telling you guys, the reason that ESP Gaming is profitable for me is because it has 8 years of video sitting on it. Every day, you know, yes, people watch the new content, but they also are watching the archives of stuff. And that's bringing in tons of views. All the archives, people going back and watching the old features, brings in tons of views and money for me. All right? That's why the channel works. Not because, oh, I'm just uploading new videos. It's because there's an 8-year legacy here attached to the ESP Gaming. All right? So that being said, I'm very nervous because what happens if I can't get my Google Plus account unsuspended? Then what happens with ESP Gaming? Is there even a way to link ESP Gaming to a new Google Plus account if I make a new one completely? I have no idea. Right now, any button that I click in the YouTube channel that you would be able to have that ability or even have anything with settings or whatever gives me a 500-page internal error. So I have no ability to do it. So anyway, I found out all about this. Okay? Found out all about this. And I say, alright, let us keep talking. I'm still in the chat on YouTube, right? All this shit is running through my head. I'm still in the chat on YouTube, right? And I say, how is it possible that my YouTube channel that's been running for 7 or 8 years has been shut down, you know, for spam because it's linked to a Google Plus account with spam, you know, suspension or whatever? How is this possible? I didn't change anything. I'm within your criteria. And she was, the person responded and said, I don't have any information. The only thing you can do is fill out this form. And she gave me a link. So I click on the link. The link is for suspended or deleted YouTube account. And I'm like, but this isn't what happened. It's my Google Plus account that's suspended. If I go to my YouTube account, I can see it's still there. It's not suspended or deleted or anything. And I said that to her. I said, are you sure this is the right form? She said, yes, that's the right form. Fill it out. I said, okay. So I filled out the form with all the information. I had an explanation paragraph, and I submitted it. And I said, all right, so what's the next step? She said, the next step is for you to wait a few days. I said, so wait a minute. So there's no one else I can talk to. I can't appeal this to any human. There's no one you can put me in contact with to go to the next step for a process. This is it. She said, that's it. You're done. That's all you can do. So now you gotta wait. She says, a few days. Now today's Wednesday, right? By the way, YouTube usually don't work on the weekends. So more than likely, I'm not gonna be hearing back from YouTube on this issue until next week.
I love you, Ren. Alright.
Yeah, that's really bad, guys. That's really bad, because that means a human may not even look at this form that I submitted until next week, and then take time to gee, you know, what happened here with the spam? Is it spam out? Hypothetically, let me let you think what I think. Okay. What happened is when Google Plus was forced to be linked with a YouTube account, alright, this was years ago, there's automatic settings that go into play, alright, for linked accounts. And I believe one of the automatic settings that's set up for Google Plus is to show new video posts on your Google Plus page. Now, I don't use my Google Plus page. I know nothing about my Google Plus page. I don't access it. I don't use it. I know nothing about it. I don't want to have a Google Plus page. I never wanted one. I do everything I do on a daily basis. I do for my YouTube channel, ESP Gaming. I don't do anything from Google Plus. It's just a stupid integration that they force, okay, your social media page or whatever. What I actually think happened, all right, in reality, what I think happened is there's some algorithm behind the scenes of YouTube that looks for spam, and for whatever reason, they turned on this algorithm on Google Plus recently, a new one probably, knowing YouTube, or knowing Google, I should say, because it wasn't necessarily YouTube staff who did this, it was probably Google staff. They turned on another algorithm, and I guess what's happening is probably on my Google Plus page, you're seeing 30 posts a day, all right, in a lot of cases with similar names. Like, for example, when I'm uploading H1Z1 gameplay, I'm not titling every video, because it's all the same. It's me doing Battle Royale style gameplay where I'm running around and shooting people. So it's like H1Z1 from June 5th, 2018, part 1. H1Z1 from June 5th, part 2. And that's how I title this video. So maybe the algorithm kind of that look and says, well, if the title is this percentage similar, if the tags are this percentage similar, if the description of the video is this percentage similar, right, flag it for spam. And maybe it has a percentage calculation by which it judges, oh, this is considered spam and this isn't. So maybe what happened is recently, as you guys know, I've been playing the Street Fighter Anniversary Collection, right? That was a lot of videos of gameplay matches. Now, most of those videos were three fights. It was, you know, 5 to 10 minute chunk of me fighting someone three times in the game. But it would be like, okay, Street Fighter 3, Third Strike from May, whatever, part one. And then each video. So maybe what's happened, and this is my guess, it's total speculation on my part, okay? But what I think happened is this algorithm ran against my Google Plus page and found so many similar titles and so many similar tags and descriptions that it viewed it as a spam post. This guy's posting the same thing over and over and over and over on Google Plus. Maybe, like on Facebook, you see annoying people on Facebook who are posting advertisements constantly everywhere. People hate that shit, right? So maybe they detected my Google Plus account was an advertisement bot, and it shut it down because it was doing automated stuff, right? I could definitely see that. I could see that happening. But how asinine is that? That again, automated process, no human to review the process, all right? And just do it. Just shut down everything. Shut down the Google Plus, which will then in turn shut down the YouTube channel. No actual human touching the process whatsoever. What a joke. Because that is a broken, awful, garbage process that's not effective. And it has now effectively shut down an 8-year-old YouTube channel to do nothing wrong. There's nothing that I've ever done wrong on BFP Gaming. I'm going to check right now. No community strikes, nothing. Nothing wrong. I didn't get any notice. That's the other thing. Again, if you go do something wrong on YouTube, you're supposed to get notice of what you did. Nothing. I've literally done nothing wrong, but it seems like some kind of a broken automated process has shut down BFP Gaming. Okay?
YouTube has been terrible. Views are down, revenue's down, everything's down. You know, I hate YouTube.
Now, here's what I'm terrified of right now. Real talk, this is what I'm afraid of. As you guys know, a lot of stuff on YouTube is automated. Now, I submitted this form. But the form I submitted isn't even for Google Plus. The form that I submitted was apparently for a YouTube channel. Okay, which, again, I didn't do anything wrong on my YouTube channel. In this form, even though it effectively the direct form, or the person who was in chat just not knowing what to do and just sent me a form and said, fill this out. I don't know. How long will it take YouTube to review the situation and get back to me and say, okay, now we're going to tell you what's going on? All right. It could take a day. It could take several days. It could take a long time. All right. It could take, like I said, what if they only read it for a week?
That's a week of money that I need to pay my bills, and a week of videos that you guys want to watch on YouTube that I can't put on. It's not about the money. It's not. I'm not here to take a paycheck.
I don't know what to do, you know? Because, you know, you think, okay, short-term solution. What can you do? Short-term solution. What can you do? Sure, if I wanted to, I could upload gameplay videos to my vlogging channel, The King of Hate Vlogs, or to my other channel, KO Gaming, where I used to do game reviews. But like I said, the main reason that this is a big concern for me is because BFP Gaming makes money because it's a legacy channel that has 8 years of videos. Yes, I do naturally get some viewership based off of the new videos I upload on a daily basis, that is true. But I make a lot of viewership and money off of the old videos, and there's no way I can upload 40,000 videos to any other channel. It's impossible. It can't happen. It would take me, no lie, probably if I sat here for a year, all right, doing no new content for you, only for a year, uploading the old videos from BFP Gaming to a new channel, it probably would take that long in order to get them all live again. And by the way, they'd be fresh videos, they would just be using YouTube search algorithm, so they wouldn't get any of those views. Like right now, if you go to YouTube and you search for, BFP Gaming or Darkside Phil or DSP plays God of War, you'll get my recent God of War playthrough, my old God of War playthrough. If there's a new channel and you type that in, you won't get anything because it's a brand new channel. It doesn't even show in search results, right? The new videos don't show up like that. So I don't even know what to do, you know? I don't, what do I do to fix the situation short term? I don't think I can. I don't think there's anything I can do that's gonna fix anything. What I can tell you is this, alright? What I can tell you guys is, I'm not giving up, but I gotta find another solution. And whether it's leaving my videos archived here on Twitch, you guys can watch the archive, which is great, but I know for a fact that archive viewership on Twitch is low, and it doesn't make a lot of money. Real talk, I know it doesn't. There are advertisements that run during the archive streams on Twitch, they're not often, and when they do, they don't make a lot of money.
Money. Plugs, money.
So you're talking, like, for example, if I was playing Vampyr on stream today, which I have not been doing, and I recorded 15 videos uploaded on YouTube, or if I make one archive video that I just need here on Twitch, I'm probably making 2 to 3 times more than that on YouTube, just for that same exact video, which I know sounds silly, but it's true, because YouTube is a more profitable place when it comes to advertising. Now, Twitch is much better because you have interaction with your stream viewers, you have something and tipping, all kinds of other stuff that comes into play that makes Twitch a profitable place. And in reality, I make more money on Twitch than I do on YouTube on a monthly basis, but not by much, okay? So, even if I say, okay, for the next few days, I'm going to keep streaming like I normally do, and I'm going to leave all my streams archived on Twitch for you guys to watch. I don't know if I'm gonna make any money off of those archives at all. I can get people more than watch them, I need nothing. There's no matter what revenue you made by it. I have no idea. Okay? And like I said, if I just upload videos to KO Gaming, for example, number one, KO Gaming was blacklisted by YouTube last year, and every video that I upload to that channel automatically gets demonetized. So not only would the videos not be getting as much attention because they're on the channel, they also be demonetized immediately, and I need to demonetize every video manually, so it would be like a waste of time. I honestly don't know what to do, okay?
I'm not a whiny baby. I'm a mature adult, and I'm not a children's entertainer.
I honestly don't know what else to do in this regard. I think what I'm going to do in the short term is I'm going to continue to stream here on Twitch, which I need to do. I'm going to rely on you guys to hopefully spread the word on what's going on so that people who are looking for my YouTube channel and what's happened to Bill's gone will realize I'm not gone. The channel was suspended for complete bullshit, all right? And that it may come back, but in the meantime, you've got to come check out all my stuff on Twitch.
And if you want to see me continue to be successful and continue to stay in, you've got to support another way. You know, whether it's watching the stream and cheering someone and cooking while I'm here on Twitch, or pledging to my Patreon, or buying something for my Teespring, you know, no matter what it might be, I'm going to need that support right now more than ever. Tips, I need it. Pretty badly. I need to raise a lot of money this year. By the way, I really desperately need the money.